Hello friends, welcome back to the channel. I am Dr. Vikas Singh Bhadauria. I am working as Associate Professor in Electrical and Electronics Engineering Department, ABS Engineering College, Ghaziabad. This college is affiliated to Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam Technical University, Uttar Pradesh, Lucknow. In today's video, I will discuss about the harmonics in DC system. This topic is related to the subject EHV, AC and DC. This subject is in the final year of the Electrical and Electronics Engineering branch of the BTech. So let us start our discussion about the topic harmonics in HVDC system. Then before discussion, first we need to know that what are the harmonics. So whenever electrical energy which is being generated at a generating station, that electrical energy is being transmitted through AC or DC transmission. And then this energy will be delivered at the consumer terminals, and at the consumer terminal it will be delivered at some specified voltage levels which is having a constant magnitude, and it is desirable that this delivered energy should not deviate from the ideal waveform. If there is any deviation from the ideal waveform or the desired waveform, then it is assumed that it contains some harmonic components in that. So we can define our harmonics as the content of electrical signals whose frequency is an integral multiple of the fundamental frequency produced by the generator. So this is a general definition of harmonics. Then why harmonic study is required in any HVDC system? That harmonics are generated, then harmonic currents on the AC side and harmonic voltage on DC side whenever the operation of HVDC is occurring. So then the harmonic currents generated on AC bus transmitted towards the AC system, and they cause a different adverse effects, and some of them are then the connected equipments will be heated, the converter control will be unstable, and it will also generate the radio interference and telephonic interference in the neighborhood communication lines. And then harmonics can also lead to the over voltages due to resonance condition. This resonance is generally known as ferroresonance. Then the sources of generation of harmonics are, one is the AC generator. This generate harmonics. Then another source is the transformer. And then third one is the converter along with its control devices. Means these are the three main sources of generation of harmonics in any HVDC system. So AC generator as a source, because in the generator the harmonics are generated because of non-uniform distribution of flux on the armature winding. Generally it is assumed that the output of AC generator contains no harmonics, but still some harmonics are present in the output of that AC generator, and those harmonics are due to the non-uniform distribution of flux. Then in the transformer, the presence of DC component in transformer secondary, there is a magnetic distortion and magnetic saturation. This magnetic distortion and magnetic saturation makes transformer as a source of harmonics. And the magnitude of these harmonics depends on the flux density. And the converter transformers are generally operated at higher flux as compared to conventional three-phase transformers. So the chances of generation of harmonics are more in converter transformers. We can see with this figure that there is a curve between flux and magnetization current. This is a magnetization curve, and this is the waveform phi is equal to phi m sine omega t, and this I m is a magnetizing current. So this is the flux which is producing in that in transformer winding, and this is the magnetizing current which is the effect of this flux. So there is a distortion in this magnetizing current. So this clearly shows that the transformer are also generating the harmonics. This is the magnetization curve without hysteresis, and same this is with hysteresis. In this also we can clearly see that this is the pure sinusoidal waveform is for the flux and the distorted waveform is for the magnetizing current. Then harmonics due to converters. So then converters produces characteristic harmonics and non-characteristics. The characteristics harmonics are normally current harmonics are of order of NP plus minus 1. And these are produced on the AC side, and the voltage harmonics are of the order N into P, and these harmonics are produced on the DC side, where N is any positive integer and P is the number of pulse. These harmonics are known as characteristic harmonics. Then the characteristic AC harmonics, we can see that this is the current IA. This is IA1, IA2, 12 pulse converter is considered. This converter transformer is connected as a star star, and this converter transformer is connected as star delta. This is the DC link current ID. This is the current waveform for IA1, and this is the current waveform for IA2. By combining this IA1 and IA2, we will find the current IA. So the IA1 plus IA2 will be equal to IA. This will be equal to 4 root 3 by pi id cos omega t minus 1 upon 11 cos 11 omega t plus 1 upon 13 cos 13 omega t plus minus 1 upon 23 cos 23 omega t plus 1 upon 25 cos 25 omega t. Since the line current of each converter will be half of total current, so IA1 will be half of this and IA2 will be half of this, and that value will be half of this, means this is 4 root 3, so that will be 2 root 3, and other parameters will be same. And if you want to find the RMS value of that current, so RMS value will be this maximum value by root 2, so we will divide by root 2 in this equation, and then further simplifying this value will be root 6 by pi into id, and the other parameters, the cos omega t minus 1 upon 11 cos 11 omega t plus 1 upon 13 cos 13 omega t and so on, these terms will remain same. So by analyzing these above equation which is mentioned in the previous slide, the fundamental and harmonics current will be, this is I1 naught, this will be equal to root 6 upon pi into id, and IHO will be equal to I10 and the upon H. This O, or we can say this is 0, this indicates that the overlap angle is 0. This I1O, this is the maximum value of fundamental current, and then IHO is the maximum value of harmonic current. If mu or overlap angle is non-zero, then the I expression for harmonic current will be different. This IH will be equal to IHO A square plus B square minus 2AB cos 2 alpha plus mu to the power 1 by 2 upon cos alpha minus cos delta, where the value of A will be this and value of B will be this, and delta will be equal to alpha plus mu, and this expression is valid for only mu is less than equal to 60 degree. This is the variation of harmonic magnitude with the variation of DC current. This is the H is equal to 5 7 11 and 13 on x-axis. This is showing the variation in x-axis. ID or DC current is increasing. Then harmonics due to again the characteristic DC harmonics, previously those were the characteristic AC harmonics. Then whenever we are analyzing the DC voltage, then we can obtain that VH will be equal to VDO C square plus D square minus 2 CD cos 2 alpha plus mu to the power 1 by 2 by root 2. Again, the value of C and D will be expressed in terms of H and mu in this way. Then non-characteristic harmonics, those were the characteristic harmonics, and non-characteristic harmonics are due to the mainly one is the imbalance in the operation of two bridges forming 12 pulse converter, because for the 12 pulse converter two bridges has to be considered, and if there is any firing angle error there is any unbalance and distortion in AC voltage, or there is transformers having unequal leakage impedances. Then the harmonics produced due to first cause, these are terms as the residual harmonics, and these are majorly due to difference in the firing angles of the two bridges. So it means this will lead to the unequal cancellation of harmonics of order 5, 7, 17 and 19. And the last three can lead to the generation of triple or even harmonics. Then the effect of firing angle errors. The major source of firing angle error in modern converter station is due to ripple in current, and the tolerance which is allowed in firing pulse should not exceed plus minus 0.2 degree. Then effect of unbalanced system voltage. This is due to the presence of negative sequence component in AC voltage, and this presence shifts the zero crossing of commutating voltage. And as we all know, then in IPC the gate pulses are generated with the zero crossing or detection of zero crossing. So in that case, the IPC introduces firing angle dissymmetry, and this will introduce the non-characteristic harmonics. With 5% negative sequence voltage, the third harmonic current generated can be as large as 5% of fundamental components. So this is the severity of the harmonic current generated. So the reference which is being consulted for the preparation of this video is the book K.R. Padiyar, HVDC Power Transmission System. If you like this video, then please like it, comment in the comment box, share it, and also don't forget to subscribe the channel for getting the latest notification about the uploading of new content. Thank you.